Hello, this is lecture number 8 on RCC water tanks, and the title of this lecture is Analysis and Design of Circular Water Tanks with Rigid Base Resting on Ground by Working Stress Method Approach. In my last lecture, that is lecture number 7, I talked about the fundamental concepts in connection with circular water tanks with rigid base resting on ground. Also, I showed tables for hoop tension coefficients, bending moment coefficients and shear force coefficients from Indian Standard 3370 part 4. We also talked about the formulae in conformity with this type of tank. Now let us move further. Now this is the behavior of tank with rigid base. That means the connection between the circular wall and the circular slab at the base is rigid here. It is not flexible. It is rigid or fixed, and therefore the wall tries to bend like that shown by this dotted blue line. And therefore the triangular water pressure created is resisted by hoop tension as well as bending moment. Now let me take one problem. Design a circular water tank for a capacity of 6 lakh liters which is resting on ground. It is fixed at the base, or the base is rigid and it is free at top. Take unit weight of water as 10 kN per meter cube. Use M30 concrete and Fe415 steel. Now straight away let us go to solution. This I have drawn a rough figure showing that the circular water tank resting on ground. Now let me provide 5 meter depth. Let the free board at the top be 300 mm, that is 0.3 meter. This total depth, I have provided depth of wall as 5 meter, and for the safety I have provided 300 mm or 0.3 meter as the free board at the top. Let D is the diameter of the tank, therefore the internal diameter from here to here, it is D. We will consider 20 mm thick waterproof plaster, that is 0.02 meter, and therefore net diameter, this inside diameter, it is called net diameter because the water will be stored for that much diameter. So net diameter is D minus 2 times of 0.02, 2 times because 20 mm on one side, so 20 mm on other side. Therefore net diameter is D minus 0.4 meter. Similarly net height will be this height 5 meter minus 0.3 for the top freeboard minus 0.02, that is the waterproofing course at the bottom also. So it works out to be 4.68 meter. Moving further, volume is 600 meter cube. Now therefore 600 is equal to pi by 4 d minus 0.04 square into 4.68, because we know that the volume of the cylinder is pi by 4 into diameter square into height, and that is equal to 600. And therefore when we solve, the internal diameter of the circular water tank works out to be 12.81 meter. Let us provide it as 12.85 meter. So this is fixed now. D is 12.85 meter, one parameter we determined it. We know the overall height is 5 meter. Now let us assume thickness of 250 mm. Now we know that normally in water tank, we try to assume the minimum thickness of the wall as 200 mm. So the range of assumption of thickness of the circular wall is 200 to 300 mm, and therefore I have taken mean of both. So I assumed it as 250 mm, that is 0.25 meter. Now already you have seen in last lecture, that is lecture number 7, that for circular water tank resting on ground with fixed base or rigid base, we take one quantity called as h square by dt. Now h is 5. Actually the water will be stored only for 4.68 meter because there is a free board of 300 mm at the top, and moreover there is a plaster of 20 mm at the bottom. But to be on the safer side, when the tank becomes full up to the top, So I will take h as phi itself to be on the conservative side. So it is phi square upon internal diameter is 12.85 into thickness is 250. So this ratio works out to be 7.78. It is a unitless quantity. Now again we have seen in the last lecture that the hoop tension coefficients are given in table 9 of Indian standard 3370 part 4. Now we know that our value is 7.78 here, 7.78, and therefore it lies between 6 and 8, and therefore we will choose only the two rows from table number 9, and here the coefficients, that is hoop tension coefficients, are given for 0h up to 0.9h. So 0h, that means at the top, 0.1h, that means 0.1 into 5 meter from the top, that is important, it is not from the bottom. So 0.9h means it is 0.9 into 5 meter from the top, that means 0.9h is near to the bottom, not to the top. So this is how the table has to be read. Now what we have to do is, this is by trial and error method actually. We have to see that where the maximum coefficients for hoop tension occur. Now if we see 0.6h, so here at h square by dt is equal to 6, it is plus 0.514, whereas h square by dt is equal to 8, it is plus 0.575. So this is the combination of maximum coefficients, whereas all other combinations, they will give the less hoop tension, and therefore that is the only reason we have to pick the coefficients at 0.6h from the top, and therefore hoop tension T is equal to that coefficient from this table into gamma hd by 2. Now how this gamma hd by 2 comes, we have seen in the last lectures. Gamma is unit weight of water, h is the total height, d is internal diameter divided by 2. Therefore T becomes 10, that is, I have considered unit weight of water as 10, into height is 5, diameter is 12.85 divided by 2, therefore it becomes 321.25 K1. Now again, when I do interpolate at 0.6H, I get K1 as 0.5684, and therefore hoop tension becomes 182.60 kN. And therefore, very importantly, the hoop steel, that is the circular rings or the hoop rings to be provided in the wall, is the hoop tension divided by sigma st, that is the permissible stress in steel. Now this value 130, it is given in table number 4, table number 4 in IS 3370 2009 part 2, that also you have seen in previous lectures. So when I solve, the area of hoop steel becomes 1404.61 mm square. Already we know that the thickness of the wall is 250 mm, and therefore the minimum area of steel required for hoop rings is given as 0.24% of area, that is 0.24 upon 100 into 1000, that is height, into thickness of wall, that is 250, so it is 600 mm square, and maximum spacing can be 300 mm. But here we have got the required steel area is 1404.61 mm square for the hoop rings, that is the circular rings to be provided in the wall, and therefore spacing of 12 mm diameter bars is equal to pi by 4 into 12 square into 1000 divided by area by 2. Here I have divided by area by 2 because I want the spacing to be provided for the steel on each face. So whatever steel I will get is total, but I want the spacing in such a way that I am going to provide the steel in the outer face as well as inner face, and therefore I am dividing the required area by 2, and when I solve, it gives me value of 161.03 mm, and therefore provide 12 mm diameter bars at 160 mm center to center on both the faces, and therefore actual AST provided is 2 times into pi by 4 into 12 square into 1000 upon 160, that is 1413.72 mm². Now moving further, we again know that tensile stress in concrete is equal to tension upon B, that is width of the wall into height 1 meter plus Poisson's ratio minus 1 into AST provided. How this formula is derived, that also you have seen in my previous lectures. So please refer my lectures of water tanks. So that is equal to 182.6 into 10 raised to 3 Newton divided by 1000 is the height, 1 meter we are considering, into 250 is the thickness of the wall, plus the modular ratio is always 280 upon 3 sigma CBC as per working stress method. It is 280 upon 3 into sigma CBC is 10 for M30 concrete. So it becomes 9.33 minus 1 into area of steel provided. And therefore, when I solve it, it becomes that sigma CT, that is the permissible stress in concrete in direct tension, becomes only 0.7 Newton per mm square, whereas the permitted value as per table number 1 of IS 3370 2009 part 2 is 1.5 Newton per mm square for M30 concrete. So here the actual stress in concrete is less than permissible, so it is okay. Now suppose if this check fails, then what we can do is either increase the thickness or increase the area of the hoop steel or simultaneously increase both, so that this condition is satisfied. Now again, this table may not be required to be solved in exam, but at least for detail, this table says that this is the depth from ground level and from 0H to 1H. That means 0 means at the base of the circular wall, 0.1H is 500 mm, that is half meter from the base slab, 0.2H like that up to 5 meter up to top. These are the various coefficients we can calculate. Then these are the tensions we can calculate. Then we can also calculate AST for the corresponding tension. That means for this much tension, this is the AST required. Then we can use various diameter of bars like 8 mm, 10 mm or 12 mm. Then we can calculate spacing like already we calculated. And then AST for T provided. So as per actual spacing, when we can calculate the area of steel provided, and even we can calculate what is the sigma CT. So in each case we can show that it is less than the value prescribed in the table. Now going next important, that is bending moment. Since the base is rigid or fixed, there will also be bending moment. So again we know that bending moment is that coefficient, that is bending moment coefficient from table 10 into unit weight of water into h cube. That is K2 into 10 into 5 cube, that is 1250 K2. Now again, when we see table number 10 from IS 3370 part 4, then again for h square by dt lying between 6 and 8, we can see that the maximum bending moment coefficients are at the base, that is at 1H. So 1H means again at the base of the circular wall, that means at the top of the base slab. So again, when I interpolate between these two values, for 7.78 K2 becomes minus 0.015047, and therefore M is equal to 1250 into that coefficient, that is minus 18.81 kilonewton meter. Minus indicates that at the bottom tension is on the liquid phase, and that is obvious also, because at the bottom it is rigid and therefore the wall will bend in such a way that tension will be inside and compression will be outside. Now already we know that thickness is 250 mm and therefore effective depth will be 250 minus 45 mm cover minus outer layer already hoop rings we have provided, that is 10 minus it is 5, that is the second layer, that is 10 by 2, and therefore total becomes 190 mm. That is the effective depth to be considered for bending moment related calculations of steel. Now we know from working stress method that M is QBD square, where D is the effective depth, B is 1000 mm, Q is moment of resistance coefficient or constant for balance section. Again we know that Q is half sigma CBC KJ. Now again sigma CBC is 10 megapascal here, that is M30 concrete upon factor of safety 3, that becomes 10. K, that is neutral axis constant, is M sigma CBC upon M sigma CBC plus sigma ST, that works out to be 0.4178. J, that is lever arm constant, is 1 minus K by 3, that is 0.86. And when I put value of sigma CBC K and J, the Q works out to be 1.79, that is value of moment of resistance constant for balance section as per working stress theory. Moving further, therefore M equal to QBD square becomes this equation, and therefore when I solve, D required becomes 102.51 mm, which is less than D available, because we know that D available is 190, whereas D required as per working stress theory is only 102.51. Now again we know that bending moment is tension into lever arm, tension is AST required into sigma ST, that is area of steel into stress in steel will give tension, into lever arm is JD, and therefore when we rearrange, the AST required becomes M upon sigma ST JD. M is already 18.81 into 10 to 6 upon sigma ST is 130 from table 4 of IS 3370 2009 part 2. J just now we have calculated 0.86, and D also we have calculated as 190, and therefore AST required becomes 885.509 mm square. This is a steel to be put in a vertical direction to take care of bending moment, and therefore provide 10 mm diameter bars at 170 mm center to center. The area works out to be 462 mm square for the full height of the wall, that is for 5 meter, plus additionally you have to provide 10 mm diameter bars at 170 mm center to center for short length of 1 meter. That means this 170 mm center to center 10 mm bars, we are providing vertical bars from bottom to top, whereas for bottom 1 meter length where the bending moment is maximum, to take care of that again we are providing 10 mm extra bars at 170 mm center to center. That means only there will be 1 meter bars at 170 mm center to center for bottom 1 meter along the circumference in the vertical direction, and therefore AST provided is 462 plus 462, that is 924 mm square. Now again this table, this much detail may not be needed in exam, but again it is given that reinforcement in wall for bending moment at various heights like we did for tension. Here only it clearly shows that for the bottom 1 meter we are providing again the extra steel. Now again from table number 11 of IS 3370 part 4, that is the table for shear force for triangular load with fixed base, again for h square by dt lying between 8 and 10, these are the two coefficients, that is 0.197, these are the two coefficients, that is between 6 and 8, 0.197 and 0.174. So here I have taken it as from this table. Now we know that maximum shear force at base is coefficient into gamma w into h square, so here h square by dt is 7.78, and therefore when I interpolate it becomes 0.177, and when I do substitute this in this formula, the maximum shear force at the base of the water tank becomes 0.177 into 10 into 5 square, that is 44.25 kilonewton. Now we know that tau v, that is a nominal shear stress, is v by bd, that is 44.25 into 10 to 3 upon 1000 into 190. Don't multiply here with 1.5 because we are not solving it by limit state method. Keep it in mind, we are doing it by working stress method, so v has to be taken as it is, that is 44.25 into 10 to 3 newton upon b into d, so it works out to be 0.2328 newton per mm square. Now we know that The percentage of steel is 100 AS by BD. Here area of steel has to be taken as the total vertical steel, not the hoop steel, but the vertical steel which you have calculated at the base, that is 924, because since we are seeing the base shear, and therefore the total steel we have to see at the base, which is 924. I have talked in the previous slides. So it is 100 into 924 upon 1000 into 190, 0.486%. Now referring IS 456-2000, we can calculate that for M30 concrete and 0.486 percentage of steel, we can interpolate and we can calculate the shear strength. Tau C is equal to 0.3 Newton per mm square for these values, and therefore here tau C is greater than tau V, and therefore it is okay. That means it is safe in shear. These are the reinforcement details. Please go through the reinforcement details. It is very easy to understand. Only one has to carefully see that here the base is provided in such a way that it acts as a rigid base. Like if it's a flexible base, then we actually provide here the sliding joint, so that there is no rigid connection between the circular base slab and the circular wall. But here we don't provide sliding joint. Moreover, we make this joint in such a way that it acts as a rigid. Thank you very much.